Alright, so our last video about Jameis didn't quite go as planned. We got a lot of accusations thrown out at us for just being ruthless dicks to him, but we were really just kidding around, and I personally really like Jameis and think he's a super talented QB. After all, there is a reason this guy was the number one pick of the NFL draft at one time. He can play. His career so far has been marred with mistakes, especially the interceptions, but at the same time, he can put up some really big numbers. Each of the past three seasons that he has played all 16 games, he has thrown for over 4,000 yards, so it is no question that Jameis can move the ball. But that said, you cannot ignore the interceptions. There is a reason he was pushed aside in Tampa Bay. Last year, he reached a new peak, or low, or fuck, I don't know, in that department, throwing 30 of them. So he does have a long way to go. Recently, Jameis took a smaller deal than he could have to sign with the New Orleans Saints, where he will back up Drew Brees and be under his tutelage along with Sean Payton. This seems to be a move by Jameis to revitalize his career by taking a step back and relearning the process of becoming a great NFL QB. The question is, will it work? I think it can work, and here are three reasons why. Number one, he could one day take over this team. Drew Brees does not have long left in the league. He has 2 years left on his deal, but you never know how everything is going to play out. Even if Drew does play his two more years, Jameis is only 26, which would make him 28 if he stays there until the end of Drew's contract, which is more than a viable age to sign a QB to a long-term deal at. I think if Jameis can remain patient and sharpen his skills, he just put himself in the perfect situation. He's going to be able to learn behind one of the best quarterbacks of all time and a dynamic offensive head coach. If he seizes the moment and proves that he can be that franchise QB that he was drafted to be, I see no reason why he can't take the reins of the Saints franchise soon. This is a much better situation for him than walking into a Jacksonville or Washington or whatever other struggling franchise wanted to sign him, where he would likely be thrown into the fire to fail or rot on the bench behind a young QB and never really get a chance. Number 2. This is a chance for Jameis to hit the reset button. A lot of people are really upset that Jameis likely wasn't going to get the chance to start this year, but personally, I'm not. I mean, like I said, he is super talented, but I don't think he has shown or proved that he is a viable starting QB right now. His career has been a rocky road and filled with criticism and mistakes, so I think it is honestly best for him to take a year or two, sit behind a great QB, and learn like a rookie again. In a recent video I did on Joe Burrow, I debuted a favorite tool of mine, the QB Success Pyramid. Essentially assessing the backing of ownership, coaching, and personnel a quarterback has behind them, and how that can play a huge role in dictating their success. I'll link that below if you want to check it out. In Tampa, Jameis' pyramid was a mess, and he had very unstable backing in many of the categories that I use. In New Orleans, none of those things are going to be a problem. Everything is going to be stable, and he can start from square one again. After all, he is only 26. He's got plenty of time. Number 3. It's a win-win. This signing is just great for both sides. For the Saints, they get a more than capable high-end backup for a huge discount, and get to keep Taysom Hill for the price that they had to pay. He may not have the consistency that Teddy brought, but if Drew goes down, they can be confident that Jameis will at the very least keep the wheels turning. And for Winston, he gets the opportunity to revitalize his career and potentially take over the team one day like we talked about. But even if the latter doesn't happen, he is likely going to be in a position to sign as a starter elsewhere. If he gets to play and showcase his ability in New Orleans, I think he's going to look better than ever. And like Bridgewater, teams will be intrigued by that. He may not be getting the money or playing time he could have elsewhere, but he set himself up for success and made the right and mature choice by signing with the Saints. So those are my thoughts on Jameis Winston signing with the New Orleans Saints. I want to hear what you guys have to think too, so comment down below. Please leave a like, subscribe to Semi-Pro. We post dope sports content every day. We'll see you guys in the next video.